Hi, and good morning, and welcome to this presentation and this webinar that we will hold on how to reduce print in your organization. We look very much forward to telling you about our pretty cool tool that that we have and that we hope you can use. And we're very excited about it, and we definitely hope that you will be too. We assure you will be too. Along the presentation, please ask your questions in the chat or in the questions window inside the GoToWebinar, and we'll keep an eye on them. Maybe we'll take the question and answer it straight away. Maybe we will put it on hold till the end if it requires a little bit of an explanation. But in either case, please do ask along the way, and let's have an interactive session rather than me just talking along here. So please do interrupt, and we wish you a very warm welcome here. So my name is Christian Winter. I'm an AI lead here at Nextagenda in Denmark. I have been working with data in all sorts of capacities in the last at least 20 years. My background is I have a PhD in astrophysics from a long time ago. I helped an international collaboration of astronomers and astrophysicists hunt planets around other stars. So just like the sun has planets, Venus, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and perhaps Pluto, if you count it, then all the other stars you see in the night sky, they actually have planets as well. And since 1995, we've been able to hunt these planets and detect them, and I've been part of that. After physics, I started working in the financial sector, and I've been working in the financial sector for almost 10 years, and after that in the consulting services for almost 10 years as well. And I'm now here at Nextagenda, which is, I should just add that with me today, I have my two fantastic colleagues, Michael Pleno and Peter Kuskov, and they will, first of all, jump in if they want to add something, if I forget to mention something. And second, they will monitor the chat and may interrupt me if there are some cool questions or any questions at all, really. They will interrupt me a little bit, which is a good help. So with that, just a few words, Peter, you will just mention here.
Yes, thank you, Christian. So to introduce Nextagenda, so we know who we are, and short five facts. So Nextagenda, we are a company started in 2014, and we are Microsoft focused partner on Microsoft technology, open source, and we have the gold data analytics and cloud certification and partner status at Microsoft. And we were acquired 100% by Konica Minolta in September 2019. And as of today, we are more than 40 data experts in Denmark. We have our employees and consultants have a high experience level, like you can hear from Christian's CV, and also have a vision and a deep passion on working with data. So everything we do, it's what evolves around data. So data is the focus of everything we do, from traditional BI and data warehouse to advanced analytics that we are talking about today, advanced analytics, data science. But we're also working with other more digitalization of business processes in the CRM power platform space. You can say around our customers, they also have a passion of data, and they are among the most innovative companies in Denmark that want to be data driven. So that's what we help them with, to achieve better results and exploit new business opportunities using data, whether it's a public company or it's a private company. And as you see on the map, Nextagenda is not just in Denmark, but our core team of the 40 more than 40 experts is in Denmark, but we are expanding across the Nordics and UK and are establishing subsidiaries inside the Konica Minolta organization on data consultancy. So over to you again, Christian.
Yeah, thank you, Peter. Thank you. So today we are talking about reducing print. That's sort of the core topic today. And just to motivate that, why would you want to reduce print? Well, we see two very, very strong reasons for doing that. And one is a thing you've all heard about, and that's the global goals and the especially the climate change. The human introduced climate change we all see and kicked off by our emission of greenhouse gases, and an urge and really burning platform here to reduce the global CO2 emission. And print is a factor in the CO2 emission, of course, not a big one, but on a global scale, but still definitely a way for companies and organizations to reduce their CO2 and their climate impact is to reduce their print. So that's definitely a very good motivation for reducing print is to reduce your climate impact. A really important topic in the global scale right now. Definitely something we should all be worried about, and a very, very good argument for reducing your print. Outside of that, other good arguments that you may weigh heavier or lighter as it fits you. Clearly, print has an environmental impact on outside of the climate change through the production of paper and electronics. That has an impact as well, and then that's the environmental side of it, and sort of being a good citizen even as an organization. And a more internal argument is of course that print costs money. There's a print the direct cost of the paper and the toner. You have the write-offs of your printers. They cost money to acquire or to lease, or however you do it. And that has a cost, and there's a service of the printer as well that costs. But what we will be focused very much on today is that print is a sign that you have some manual processes, and maybe you would want to digitize or automate some of these manual processes. Definitely, if you're printing something, there's a human that's printing something, and that human is probably also scanning the printed document afterwards, and someone is doing something with that piece of paper that we probably would argue could be digitized or automated, and not printed. So print is a sign that you're doing something manual that maybe we should consider you shouldn't be doing manually. Our little bit rhetoric question here is how can you reduce your print if you don't know what you're printing? Well, you cannot. That's obvious. You cannot reduce your print if you don't know what you're printing. So what we are offering here is an analysis of what you're printing. That's really what SWS is, to cut to the chase, is an analysis of what are you printing. It's more than that, but that's the core product here. We will analyze for you what you're printing. That is what we are offering mainly today. There's other things to it as well. That's the main product. We will tell you what you're printing in your organization. And through that, we have a process of reducing your print as well. I'll come back to that. So, prime product is you do not know what you're printing, and we will help you identify that. But of course, that's not enough, because if you know what you're printing, you have to understand why you're printing it. So you need to identify that. But the core aim of this whole thing should, of course, be to reduce your print. So often the way to reduce your print is to increase digitization of your processes. We find that it's rarely enough to go ask someone, why are you printing those documents? And they say, blah, 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 because I need it for some reason. And they are probably right. They need it to be printed. That's not the way you reduce your print. You cannot go and knock someone on the head and tell them to stop printing. We find that there are some digitization projects you need to implement some digitization or automation of your workflows to reduce your print. But at least the first step definitely is to understand what you're printing. And then we can find out why and how to reduce it later. So how we understand what you're printing is that we install some software on one of your machines that collects the image logs, the basically what has been printed and scanned and copied. And we analyze that using artificial intelligence or machine learning, whatever you want to call it, and produce some report that I'll show in a minute about what you have been printing and scanning and copying. I should mention, this is very important to stress, all of this takes place in your environment. Of course, analysis of what you're printing is quite a sensitive operation because this accesses some potentially very sensitive documents, and there's also some employees might feel that we are sort of sniffing around on their work. So we have some templates of what to write to the employees, and now we're doing this. Maybe we do it in some areas and not in the most sensitive areas if needed. Definitely we have to be aware that this is a sensitive issue to go and analyze what we're actually printing, potentially sensitive. And very importantly, this whole work stays in your environment. No document leaves your environment, no data leaves your environment, unless for some reason you want to, but as a general, it does not leave your environment. The analysis, the documents, the information gathered from the print stays in your document, unless there's a reason not for that from you. All right, and all the machine learning software is installed on your environment. This is very important. Okay, this whole AI machine learning thing, of course, is part of a broader trend that we are very focused on here in Nextagenda and Konica Minolta, of making unstructured data structured. Right, that's what this is, so fundamental to how we're going to work in the next decade or maybe even more. Of that, we have all this unstructured data: images, emails, Excel spreadsheets, backup images. We have CSV files and all sorts of documents lying around on SharePoint drives, on all sorts of funny places. And what we are very focused on these days is structuring this data. And this is just one example, and one very cool example, in our opinion, of how we take this unstructured data, this data going everywhere and in all kinds of formats, in this case, image data, which is very difficult to add structure to, actually. And we make it structured. We say, what are the categories as a first thing? What are the categories in these images? Taking unstructured data and making it structured is a very big trend. You've probably heard a lot about the last few years, and you will definitely hear more about in the coming years. I'm certain of that. It's a very big topic. Feel free to interrupt there, Peter and Michael, as you see fit. All right, so in this case, what we all this unstructured data is your image log from your print server, all the things you've been scanning, copying, and printing, we categorize it. And a pretty cool thing, in my opinion, is that we actually categorize it in your categories. You define the categories that you wish your print jobs to be categorized in. And then we use this machine learning AI software to categorize documents in your categories. So if you are an accounting company, your categories are different than if you are a production company or a sales focused company, a sales organization, or a public organization, a municipality. The document types you have in your organization are very different from organization to organization. We've worked with many of them. And we are able to categorize with an incredible accuracy, 90%+ of the documents are categorized correctly and will reflect the categories that you recognize. So
Christian, maybe we should add that, of course, we have when we usually do a project of SWS analysis, then we have a standard set of categories also. So typically, maybe 80% of the categories we use are the standard categories that we always use, but then we together with the customer define and add some customer specific categories. And you can say in a municipality, it could be something like case management in the building application area, or it could be some type of internal documents for management, etc. In the municipalities, there's a lot of different, or it could be drawing of the local area and local area plans, etc. So it's just to give an indication of what we can, or what we usually do.
Yeah. Whereas some of the examples we see here, presentations, meeting agendas, emails, invoices, they are common to all the organizations we see, to be honest, right? Exactly. Good point, Peter. Thank you. All right. So we categorize what you are printing in your organization. All right. And the product of this first step, this very essential step, is a report that I'll just show you briefly here how a report like this might turn out in any organization. So sorry, I was just on the wrong page. I'm just starting on the right first page. There we go. So a little dashboard here that shows for each department. In this is demo data. I can't show data from some Danish municipality or something like that on what they've been printing in a demo. That'd probably be a bit of an issue. So it's some demo data. And in this imaginative organization here, we have three printers, one placed in management, one in the administration, and one in the arts department, whatever that is. And we get a little dashboard here that definitely management are the heavy users of the print. They print 8,000 documents, and then some 2,000 and 3,000 for the other departments, respectively. We see the average pages per document, also we have some information about GDPR compliance that I'll come back to in a second about social security numbers and names in the documents. Come back to that in a minute. For now, let's just see that we get some high-level info here, and we can actually dig deeper into the jobs on their three printers here and get a very detailed overview of what's been going on in this organization. And I apologize, this is maybe a little bit confusing to someone who's not used to this particular product called Power BI. It's a modern reporting product. Those of you that are used to it will hopefully find it a little bit more familiar. It's a little busy. People who get this report, our customers on the SWS product, find it very informative, and there's a lot of info here. What it enables us to do is to see on all the different job types and all the different printers for all the different users, for all the different time periods, and the different categories we have identified, what is being printed. So a very heavy information here. And just to show you a little bit around, here we see how many documents are printed per day, mainly in November here, I see. But we can actually filter that down to more precise. If I want to know what my old friend, who have we got here, AGX, my old friend here, what's this person been up to? Well, mainly presentation printing, but also some and scanning and all of that, but also some logos, some guidelines, some personal documents even. Maybe there's a wedding coming up here, and even some law texts as well. And I see that this person is mainly printing a few copies and a few scans, right? 98% of the pages are print. And I can dig into it in any way I want, but for now, let's skip AGX and just see, let's just see what categories actually we're printing We have the categories here. We see that it's mainly presentations we are printing. Okay, so let's just filter it down on presentation and see what's actually going on with that. What is going on here? Okay, so management are the big sinners here. Sinners are maybe a little harsh. Are the heavy consumers of presentation, and it's mainly printing going on. So I can even just filter it down on the printing. So now I'm on presentations printed, and we see we can see when it's happening and by which department and even at what time of day. We can get this very detailed analysis on any level that we wish.
And actually also a detail is on the far left, you can see what day of is the being printed most. Yes. And you can actually see that there's some specific dates like the 23rd and the 2nd of November.
Something
so
crazy.
Can be worked in the dialogue.
Yeah, exactly, Peter. Yeah, go on, please. Yeah, you're right.
So this is an example of how you try to drill down into understand what's behind the printing of presentations. So who is doing it? When is it done? By which department? And this information is what SWS analysis provides, that you can take this and start a dialogue with the business to say, so why are you printing presentations on this stage? Because maybe they're not aware of it, and try to kind of map and understand the processes and reasons behind this to see if there is there any potential to make it more efficient and change these processes. Right? Mm-hmm. So this is how you can use the tool to support the dialogue you will have to map what's going on.
It seems simple, but it's powered by some incredibly advanced technology underneath with machine learning and AI. But the product is actually, at the end of the day, pretty simple. It's so awesome.
So, Christian, we actually have a question also.
Oh, great. Yeah. Bring it on.
So Eric Asker is asking, can you give some examples on type of customers where you have analyzed print with AI? And we have been working, you can say, with municipalities. Is one of the key areas of customers, but also in the services industry, we have been working with customers and are working also in different manufacturing companies. But so it's a quite wide range, and our experience is that very much depends on the type of. So one services company may not compare to another because one services company may have a lot of manual work, right? A lot of technicians that get manual work orders or whatever. You can have a very different pattern depending on the type of company you have, what categories you want to see. But of course, like we said, so our experience is that it's more the basic, maybe up to 10 to 20 categories, that's the generic categories, and then we add 5 to 10 that is customer specific on top of that. So that's something that we always work with the customer with. And if that answers your question, Eric, please then feel free to answer more or raise your hand.
We hope so. Otherwise, please come back, please, and ask again if there's any follow-up to that. Excellent. Peter, actually, you're on again.
And Michael, did you want to ask something?
Yeah, okay, just very briefly. So in general, I just think that the type of customers that we typically engage with is also customers that really want to enhance that digitalization further, right? Because that is really one of the key and core focus areas with this little exercise here, is really to identify a good roadmap for how a customer can digitalize further. So it's typical, and those companies has actually been proven to be quite a widespread, right? So it's both, as you said, municipalities, it's been production companies, and quite a few also, as they are returning back from this COVID situation, is lining up for this exercise, right? So very broad range.
Yeah. So how do we do this analysis when we engage at a customer? So this is kind of the single analysis where we come in, do analysis of a set of MFPs and output a result that we present and deliver to the customer, and then that's the SWS analysis. Let's talk, but we'll talk more into that. So it starts, of course, with takes overall in 5 to 6 weeks, and we of course we have to collect data from the printing, and usually we collect data for a full month because we want to have that cycle of a month, the business cycle of a month. So we can start anytime, of course, in the month, whatever needed. And then when we have collected data from the selected printers, then we categorize them using AI, and we present and deliver the results in a Power BI report to the customer. So of course that's the kickoff meeting where we discuss what's the process and scope and timing and what are the resources needed from the customer side and roles in the process and to kind of maybe dive into that. Then of course we need someone who can be responsible for the project and understand the customer's business, so we can discuss what type of categories should we use. Do you have any input, or do you want it to be us who kind of are creative and from the information you give us we recommend some categories? That's a normal process. And then of course there's also a technical side, so we need to run this on your environment, IT environment is what's typically done. So of course we have to have some type of IT technician that can provide us with the access and also the necessary servers where this will run on. We can also run it in a cloud service if you want that, then it's more simple for you. But this is a quite simple process to set up. So we set up the installation of the SWS, and we set up the collection of data from the printers, and we define which printers we want to collect data from, which is of course important. Like Michael said, where is it that you see a potential for digitalization, or have an idea that there is? That's where we will start collecting data, and then we have the analysis and the categorization with AI. Which is running for it's a very fast process, takes a half a day or something like that, and then we output the results to a Power BI report written in Danish in this slide, but I think it's almost the same word. It is output in a Power BI desktop file, so we can deliver the report directly to you whether you have a Power BI license or not. If you have a Power BI license, then you can publish it in your Power BI environment. And we run through this report and explain to you how to use it and what the results means and where you should look for potential digitalization. And then in the next steps, yes, we will try to walk you through what we see as how to work with the next steps on digitalization and what ideas and what to look for. So, Christian, I think we are hitting the next slide.
As you as well.
So the SWS analysis, that's what has been printed in different categories and by whom and in which department and at what time, right? So we have a quite a broad analysis of what has been printed. So the next thing is to understand why was it printed, to talk to the business users, understand the processes, And then from that, when you have an understanding of not all the processes, but of course where you see potential, and doesn't have to be the categories where you have the number one amount of print. It could be others that we usually see where there is more potential, right? So why was it printed? And from that, try to understand how to then create more efficient automation of manual processes. One tool we have is the classic digitalization, where you digitalize a manual process. And you have different tools for that. You have some document management tools like M-files. That could be like e-signature part of that. That could be handling of how to approve a document, etc. It could also be the Power Platform, where you can create apps. We will get back with some examples, right, Christian, on some apps you can create with the Power Platform, which is very simple. We also return with some get back with some examples on how to use AI, because AI is actually, you can use that to kind of put digitalization on speed. That's really going fast forward on the digitalization processes, where you have opportunities to digitalize that you haven't had before without making a revolution. That's also the example we give. This is just reducing AI where it's possible to replace part of a process, but maybe saving, both getting higher quality, but also spending lot less time. Tedious manual work will be replaced. And of course, doesn't have to be a technical solution to automate a manual process. It can be a simple change management, just changing of how you do your work, making it more lean. And one other output you have to look at when, why was this printed? Do we comply to the GDPR regulatives that we have? Does this follow? Are we printing a lot of, it's a possibility as an add-on to the SWS analysis to get information on GDPR sensitive information like social security numbers, etc. And another compliance factor that you have to look at is, do this contribute to the company's climate goals, right? Do we see the reduction that we want in print over the years? If you have, maybe you want to reduce to 20% of the print you have today in 2030, then you want to see a development and a reduction. And that brings us to the last box on this slide. That is, one thing is doing a one-time SWS analysis. Another thing that we see some of our customers moving into is doing continuously analysis of SWS. And this gives you as a customer two great opportunities. It is, one is to follow up on what has been changed. You know, if you have been automating processes, then you want to look at, was this effective, and what other categories do you want to look into. But it also gives you the opportunity to move and add additional printers across the company, moving from finance department to production or to HR, you know, moving to the sales department, taking in all the departments in the company over the years and working with them, both from an overview of what's been printed, but also with the purpose of digitalizing and making more efficient. So this is at least a possibility to do with SWS, which we think is very relevant, because it's a tool that can run just without any local on your environment and without any issues with GDPR, etc. So this would give you continuous insight to work with the output from print and see the opportunities of digitalization. So Christian, next slide, I think we'll dive into what's possible with AI.
We I spoke earlier about this trend that we see of making unstructured data structured. I think you can see this is something close to my heart. And another way of making unstructured data structured is when you have these texts or really these images, it's pretty easy to convert them to text. This is pretty old technology called optical character recognition. But new algorithms have really been sharpened lately that can extract very specific information from a text and thereby from an image of a text. And convert that into structured data and take out very specific pieces of text. For example, this little Wikipedia text I snipped from about a war hero. You can extract, you can tell the algorithms to take out every time a name is mentioned. It'll go into the text and extract the names and put create output, structured output, of which names were mentioned, which specific names were mentioned in the text on the image. And similarly, in this case, the social security numbers that I've just inserted randomly of these people, it actually goes in and finds the social security number of these 300-year-old war heroes here and extracts them into structured data, right? So getting this unstructured mess of a text that you have in your documents, we all have in our documents, and taking out just the information you need is a very big trend. And I see this question, I'll definitely look forward to answering it in just a sec. In this concrete example, what we do with it is we go in and analyze what GDPR relevant info do you have in your prints and your scans and your copies. Are you printing out GDPR relevant information, sensitive information, and are you aware of it? Of course, there's nothing wrong with printing a social security number, but are you aware you're doing it? And do you understand why you're printing these social security numbers? And do you know how often you do it? This is the kind of questions we sort of, as an add-on to SWS, can help you analyze.
Maybe so I have two questions.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So Eric Asker is asking, do I understand your solution as a software which you install in the customer's print server and thereafter analyzing the data with Power BI?
Yes, no. it's some software, but it's first some machine learning models that we actually run on your server.
We are not running it on the print server. We are running on a server in the customer's environment, a standard Windows server. So
and it looks at the image log and collects the image log and analyzes it with some machine learning technology, and it writes it typically to a SQL server. What's called MySQL server that we installed together with it, and then Power BI. This is very technical, I'm sorry, but since you ask, Power BI does the reporting on top of that SQL data.
Yeah, so you can say all the analysis is happening in the machine learning engine at the server, and then it outputs the results, and it is structured in a database, and Power BI is then they're doing the reporting or the front end to the output of the machine learning analysis and the data collected from the printers. And then we also have a question from Andreas, I think.
Andreas.
Does it check the mail also for sensitive information?
No, but it's a very, very cool question, Andreas. So the first answer is no. This is about what your MFP, multifunction printer, I think it stands for, your printing devices, what they do. This is what this SWS technology is about. But I'll come back to how this evolves into something with emails, Andreas. So maybe I can put you just on hold for about 2 minutes and come back to emails, because it's a very relevant question. All right, So sort of an add-on to SWS, and let me just show the reporting that is resultant right here, where we have the software analyze which names and social security numbers, just as an example, it could be a lot of other GDPR relevant information, which of these snippets of data are in your prints. And then in Power BI here, we show which accounts of how many documents and how many pages, et cetera, contain these quite sensitive information. And of course, it's still just demo data, just to underline that. And we can even see who prints sensitive data and in which department and in what category, in what categories are the sensitive data. Why actually do we have three names and let's just find some crazy IT documents. Why do we have social security numbers in our IT documents? Is that really necessary? Do we understand why this happens? We see why there may be names in IT documentation, but do we really need social security numbers in IT documentations? These are all in law texts, right? These are the kind of questions we can analyze together with you and possibly map where you're doing things you possibly shouldn't be doing.
All right. So you can say, Christian, that the technology that you show here to identify social security numbers and names, etc., that would be exactly the same technology or algorithm that we're using if we want to do that in a mail or in a document on a document drive or in SharePoint or wherever. That's exactly the same. And that's also what we have done in the next case, I guess, where we have seen that a customer that there was a lot of printed emails and diving into that discussion, then actually the customer we got closer to what's the business process behind this, which led us to the next project you are describing here, right?
Yeah. So it turned out that in this organization, which is a labor union, the rule is that they have to be notified when someone in their competence area will be fired. So if someone in this sector are fired in the Danish workplace, or even if their employer plan to fire them, then this membership organization, this labor union, has to be notified, right? So they
by the
employer has to notify the labor union, and this results in a lot of emails because we have open markets and people come and go, and a lot of people are fired, and this leads to a lot of emails that have to be manually processed inside the labor union, and it's about 1 to 2 full-time employees just handling these emails. And what this software really enables, sort of on the edge of SWS, is actually the same software underneath, because it does the same. It does just what we described. It categorizes the, in this case, emails and not the printer images. It categorizes the emails and sees, wow, this email looks like a notification about a firing, and it extracts the relevant information, just like we saw before with the social security numbers. In this case, it extracts the employer and the employee name, the employer's employee's address, and all this relevant information from the email about the potential firing or the actual firing, and it processes that email, right? And replaces all the manual processes that follow from receiving this email inside the labor union. It replaces all those manual processes with a digitized and automatic filling out, in this case, of the case handling system. I hope, Andreas, from before, this exemplifies how you can take the SWS software and actually use it in a lot of clever ways to any one of you that receive emails, and some of the categories of emails, you extract some information from the email, and do something manually with that email. And everyone, you can raise your hand and say that happens in your organization, I promise you. All of you where this happens, and that is all of you, this could very well be replaced by machine learning and some automation apps that recognizes specific categories of emails, extracts the necessary information for an automation of the process that you do manually with these emails. And please come
so
back.
So basically, Christian, what we do is that we are able to integrate or read the mailbox from this company, where there is 50 to at least 50,000 emails they receive each month. And then we do what you call a mail routing. And in the process of routing or directing the email to another mailbox or to another person, then we are analyzing the mails with the AI and using different AI machine learning techniques to do that. Whether it's just to categorize or it's also to extract information and pass that information on and to do the correct redirection or routing of email. So this is a very generic way to, it can be applied to a lot of business purposes within, for instance, mail routing, right? And that's also what we see, that it has a very wide, whether it's private companies or public companies or whatever it is, then public sector is the same.
I hope it answers your question. Otherwise, please come back to us. And as Peter was almost already hinting, this has a lot of applications. We just saw email automation of email processes is a very obvious one that we see very often. Invoices, you get all these invoices on email typically, actually, or even in a letter form, and they have to be resorted and given out to some mid-level manager that has to approve them. And this person, yes, you got it, prints it out, signs it, scans it in, and has the secretary possibly send it back to the economy department, financial department, and they maybe even print it out again and put it in a filing cabinet. All of this is what we identify through AWS and say, oh, could we maybe also help you digitize this process? Or could you yourself maybe, maybe we don't have to do any of the digitization. It's quite possible. It's just buying some off-the-shelf invoicing software. That's perfectly fine. But we'll be very happy to help you identify that this is where you print a lot of stuff. HR documents. Anyone that's tried changing company will know that they get when they start. Here's your employment contract. Here's an NDA. You have to sign for the key. You have to sign for your computer. You have to sign that you won't use your computer for anything bad. You have to sign blah, blah, blah for the door code and all this stuff. And it's all printed. And it probably is printed by the team lead, who then has to give it to the new employee, return it and scan it in and send it to the HR department. Why not just use some off-the-shelf software, DocuSign or whatever it's called, to and maybe some case handling flow around it if needed, but at least just sign the documents with some off-the-shelf software. We'll be very happy to identify that. Why are you printing thousands of key signing documents in your organization? That's crazy. Work orders, I think this is in many, even small companies nowadays in the Nordics, this is digitized already, but if you're still printing out for your electricians, the work orders that they have to go fix a light bulb in office 365 and come back when they're done, digitize that. There's a lot of software ready, or you can use the Power Platform easily to automate work order process, which is there's no need for printing anything in that. Order forms I'm always just mentioned in as a new employee, you have to order a new computer, you have to order a new key, you have to order password and all this stuff. But I bet you in your organization, if you want to order catering for a meeting with some external customers, you have to print some order form for the canteen and fill it out and scan it, and then the canteen will print out your order for three pieces of breakfast, and they will make the breakfast and give it to your meeting room on this specific date, right? That's two documents printed just to order food for your canteen from your canteen. And inspection handling is one we've seen actually also that this process is typically by government agencies. They go out and inspect something, ships, building sites, restaurants, tax inspections. All these inspections have a lot of print and a lot of manual processes following that, where the inspection documents are printed and filled out by hand, maybe even, and then signed and scanned back in and sent to the case handling system. And that's, of course, completely nuts and should be digitized. Some examples, I hope you recognize some of them. Maybe I characterized it a little bit. It's definitely something we see. Many of these kind of documents are printed, and they are all signs that you're doing something. We are doing something manual that we don't need to do. All right. We'll finish up now. So we have plenty of time, and please come with your questions along the way. But maybe you type them up, and Peter will just finish as far as small as.
So how do we get started with this, right? So the base price for doing an SWS analysis for 1 month of printing on a selection of up to 5 km MFP devices is 5,000 euros. But this is something that you should discuss with your local KM subsidiary account managers that you have contact to. Take the dialogue with them on how to proceed with a project like this. But this is kind of a process that can be started very, very fast. If you want to, if you talk to us today, then in 6 weeks' time, you can have the results of this analysis delivered to you. So this is quite efficient. But of course, usually it takes a little bit longer before we have the initial dialogue to the project output, the analysis, because there's some coordination also internally in the customer's organization. But we are ready to do this and can deliver within a very, very short time frame. So reach out to your local KM account manager, and they will make sure that you are getting the right advice and what information that you need to engage and start up a SWS analysis project. Yes, Christian, yeah, and then you're very welcome, right, to get back to either of us, Michael Plino, who is the head of Nextagenda International, and myself, and of course, Christian Winter. And especially also your local KM account managers. Please reach out to them as well if you have any questions. So any last questions?
And if not, we will thank you very, very much for your participation and your attention here today. We are so excited about this project, not only from a technology standpoint using machine learning advanced analytics, but also reducing print and our little impact on global CO2 emissions. We think is a fantastic project, this SWS thing, and we are very happy about it, and we are very happy for you to have participated, and thank you very much for that, and I wish you an onwards good day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.